Hello dear students, in previous videos we have discussed about the various aspects of the reproductive health. We have also discussed about the terms such as MTP, that is medical termination of pregnancy, STDs, that is sexually transmitted diseases. A discussion on reproductive health is incomplete without the mention of infertility. So in this video we are going to discuss about infertility. A large number of couples all over the world, including India, are infertile. That is, they are unable to produce children in spite of unprotected sexual cohabitation. Infertility means not being able to become pregnant after a year of trying. If a woman can get pregnant but keeps having miscarriages or stillbirth. Stillbirth means dead babies born. That's also called as infertility. Infertility is fairly common. After 1 year of having unprotected sex, about 15% of couples are unable to get pregnant. The reasons for this could be many: physical, congenital, diseases, drugs, immunological, or even psychological. The top reasons for infertility are poor sperm count in men and polycystic ovarian disorder in women. 41% causes for infertility are due to poor sperm count, while around 40% are due to polycystic ovarian disorder in women, that is PCOD. What causes male infertility? The top reasons are obesity. It is one of the reasons for male infertility due to intense physical exertion, hot temperature. You know that sperm can't survive at hot temperature. So it also causes sperm incapability, resulting in infertility of the male. Intake of performance enhancing supplements, substance abuse, as well as chemo and radiation therapy. These are the causes of male infertility. And what are the common reasons for infertility among women? The common reasons are cervical conditions, that is medical conditions, hormones and their effects on ovulation. If any woman is taking hormonal medication, it also affects on ovulation, age, uterine causes, as well as damage to the fallopian tube. The probable causes of infertility. These are also the probable causes of infertility. Too much stress is very harmful. Then obesity, intake of caffeine, large intake of coffee, tea, etc. Intake of alcohol, smoking, extreme exercise. It also results in infertility. These are the probable causes of infertility. First cause is stress. Too much stress is very harmful. Obesity, intake of caffeine, alcohol, smoking, as well as extreme exercise. In India, often the female is blamed for the couple being childless, but more often the problem lies in the male partner. Infertility clinics could help in diagnosis and corrective treatment of some of these disorders and enable these couples to have children. The couples could also be assisted to have their children through certain special techniques. These special techniques are commonly known as assisted reproductive technology. Now we will discuss what are these assisted reproductive technologies. The various types of assisted reproductive technology are IVF, that is in vitro fertilization, IUI, that is intrauterine insemination, intrafallopian transfer, ICSI means intracytoplasmic sperm injection, that is GIFT, which means gamete intrafallopian transfer. ZIFT means zygote intrafallopian transfer. So these are the various types of ART, that is assisted reproductive technology. So first technique is in vitro fertilization. In short, we call it IVF. So here are the various steps of IVF technique. First step is stimulation of ovaries in the female partner. So these ovaries are stimulated with the help of pills or injections. Once the ovaries are stimulated, then eggs are removed from the ovaries by the technique known as laparoscopy. At the same time, sperms are also removed from the male partner. Then third step is fertilization of eggs. The eggs and sperms, these are fertilized in the lab, in vitro, means in glass. That's why it is known as in vitro fertilization. After fertilization, in the day 0 to 5, embryo cultures are found. Then the healthy embryos are selected, and then these healthy embryos are transferred to the mother's body with the help of laparoscopy. The excess embryos are freezed. Then after 14 days of embryo transfer, the pregnancy test is done. So these are the various steps of in vitro fertilization or IVF. Second type is ZIFT. ZIFT stands for zygote intrafallopian transfer. Zygote intrafallopian transfer is an infertility treatment used when a blockage in the fallopian tube prevents the normal binding of sperm to the egg. In this technique, the egg cells are removed from a woman's ovaries and in vitro fertilized. Then the resulting zygote is placed into the fallopian tube by the use of laparoscopy. In this figure, you can see how the eggs are placed after fertilization. That is, zygotes are placed into the fallopian tube by the technique which is known as laparoscopy. In the figure, you may see the tube. See, this process shows the ZIFT technique. First step is eggs are aspirated from the ovary, means the eggs are removed. Then these eggs are placed in the prepared semen sample, means these are allowed to mix with sperm, so fertilization takes place. Third step is the fertilized embryos or zygotes, these are transferred into the fallopian tube with the help of a tube. This technique is called as laparoscopy. With the help of this laparoscopy, the fertilized eggs or zygotes, these are transferred into the fallopian tube, and then the normal pregnancy continued. Next technique is GIFT. GIFT stands for gamete intrafallopian transfer. With GIFT, sperms and eggs are placed in a fallopian tube to allow fertilization in the natural site. For this, the woman must have at least one normal open fallopian tube. Generally, this technique is useful for the woman with the blocked fallopian tube. If that woman is having at least one normal open fallopian tube, this technique is helpful. The sperms and eggs are placed into a fallopian tube with the help of laparoscopy. The next is artificial insemination or AI. So in this technique, the first step is stimulation. In this step, the ovaries are stimulated with hormones. Second step is control. The ultrasound controls the size and number of follicles. Third step is the release of an egg from the follicle. The intake of hormones, it stimulates the release of an egg cell. And fourth step is preparation of the semen sample on the day of insemination. The husband must pass a sperm sample, and then the expert will select in the laboratory only the highest quality of sperm. Once the sperms are obtained, on the day of ovulation, the selected sperm cells are injected into the woman's uterus using a thin catheter. Here in this image you can see the selected sperm cells are directly injected into the woman's uterus using a thin catheter. So this technique is called as AI or artificial insemination. Next technique is intrauterine insemination, that is IUI. It is a fertility treatment that involves placing sperm inside woman's uterus . The goal of IUI is to increase the number of sperm that reach the fallopian tube and subsequently increase the chance of fertilization. In this image you can see the IUI technique. Though options are many, all these techniques require extremely high precision, handling by specialized professionals and expensive instrumentation. Emotional, religious and social factors are also responsible to discourage the adoption of this method. Since the ultimate aim of all these procedures is to have a children, in India we have so many orphaned and destitute. Destitute means the kids without money, food or a home. So in India there are so many orphaned and destitute children. Our laws permit legal adoption. So adoption can be the best way to have the baby. Our laws permit legal adoption and it is as yet one of the best methods for couples looking for parenthood. Adopting one child won't change the world, but for that child the world will change. So the parents, the couples who want to be parents, they can choose this way to adopt one child. Thank you.